Record functions in Power Query. Now in this video we are going to learn how to use record functions in Power Query. Now let me just talk about what is record exactly. So if you will see, here we have a simple record. Let's say here we have source and I have written a simple record, that is A is equal to 1. In earlier example, I have told you we don't need double quotes over here because this is a simple variable. So what in record, whenever in record terms we are talking about, we are calling it as field, and anything which is written to right side of equal to sign, that is called as values. Now this concept will help you to understand the record functions. So let's begin with record functions, and if you will see, here we have record from list. So let's try record from list. So here we have our blank Excel. Now I'm going to load my Power Query. Here is data tab, get data, launch Power Query editor, click on new source, other source, and blank query. Now I'm just opening my advanced editor. Here what I need to do, I need to use first function, that is record from list. And if you will see the arguments, here we have two arguments, list as list and filled as any. Just visualize that record which I have just taken as an example, and if you will see A is equal to 1. In that example, A is your field. So what I will do, I will simply, let's say I am writing a list 1, 2, and 3. So it means I need to type here values, and here is the values, comma, I need to type the fields. So let's say A, comma B, comma C, and you will see fields are here and values are here. So this will create a record, even three record this time we are going to create. So click done, and you can see that's how record from list is working. Now why we are doing this? Let's say if you have big table and you want to refer, let's say on fifth row or sixth row every time, because let's say your software is extracting a table and in sixth line item a serious content is written over here that we need to extract again and again. So that's why this kind of record and list is very important. So let's try to understand the second function in the list, that is record.addField, and the name is very clear. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a field, extra field I'm going to add in it. Let's say here we have three fields, 1, 2, and 3. Now I'm going to add one more. Now just open the advanced editor, and here I'm going to put comma, and here I'm going to use record dot add field. Now I'm simply putting a variable name, so that's why I'm removing the dot over here. Now I'm going to use the formula once again, and here you will see, here we have three arguments, 1, 2, and 3. Record as record. So if you will see, source is also a record, so I can simply put source. Now I need to give field a name. Let's say I want to enter the fourth field, that is D, and the value, let's say I am putting this time as a text, vehicle and gen. You will see I am putting a space, and that is I'm going to enter in double quotes. Here we need to give double quotes, because if you it is asking me field as text, and every text is in double quotes, and values as any means you can enter date, number, logical, text, anything you can enter in it. So that's why I am entering a text, and text means anything which is in double quotes. Now just close the parentheses and done. I have not put this record.addField at the last. We need to put here. Just click on done, and you will see the fourth record is here. So that's how record.addField is going to work. Now I'm going to use the third function in the list, that is record.removeFields. Again, the name is very clear. This time I'm going to remove the field. So simply just open the advanced editor, and here we have, now click on advanced editor. Now again I am putting comma and I am again writing the code. Remove field. I don't need this dot because I am again creating a variable. Record. Remove fields. Now here it is asking me record. So if you will see, this is again a record. I can simply copy it, paste it. I don't need the space, comma. Now here we have field as any. So let's say you want to remove the field B and you need to just give the name. Again, it is asking me as any, so I can enter anything. Done. Again, I forgot to put the name at the last. Done. And you will see B has gone. So that's how remove record dot remove field is going to work. So let's say here we have record dot select fields. So name is again very clear. So it is going to select a specific field. Let's say you have 10 records and you want to select 2 records. Then what you need to do, if you will see the syntax over here, record dot select field record, and here we need to put field's name. So we can simply put field's name. Now let me just show you. Let's say I want to take A and D, so advanced editor, comma, record dot select field, remove this dot, equal record select fields. Now here I'm going to put the record dot remove fields. I am taking the reference of this one, comma, fields as any. Let's say I'm entering A and D. Just close the parentheses, copy it, paste it here, and done. We need to put that thing in list. Let me tell you why. Because if you will see the arguments once again, here the second argument is fields as any. So here we have only one option to put multiple fields. So if you want to put multiple fields in one field, then we can use list like a array function in your Excel. So that's why I am putting curly bracket over here. We need to simply close the parentheses and done. And you will see this time we are getting A and D. So that's how record dot select field is going to work. Here we have field values. So that function is going to extract field value from the record. Let's say here we have 3 records, A, B, and C. So what is going to do? It is going to just extract the 1, 2, and 3. Let me show you. Here, let's say again I'm putting comma, and here I'm going to use record field. Values, and again I don't need this dot, and equal record field values, and here it is asking me record, so I am simply copying the name. So it will give me the value of A and D. Just put the close parentheses and copy it, paste it here, and done. Now you can see 1 and Vikal Jain. So what it has done, it has created a list of values. So now here we have field names. So if instead of field values you want to extract field names, you can do that. And if you want to search anything, let's say record has field. Now here if you will see the example, here we have record A1, B2 and C3. Now what is it is going to do? It is going to search that record and find that record. Means if I'm going to talk about A and D, so it is going to search A and D. If A is there, it is going to fetch that. If D is there, it is going to fetch that. Let's say if D is not there, and you will see in this example D is not here, So it is going to fetch only A. So record dot combine, if you will see here we have record in the list, first list. So it will combine all the record. Let me show you. So let's say here I am clicking advanced editor, comma. Now this time I am going to show you how to use record dot combine. And so let's say here we have records dot combine. Now it is giving me record as list. So let's say here we have record A is equal to 1, comma, B is equal to 2, comma. Here we need to put a record in the list. And the third one is C is equal to my name. Just copy it, paste it here, and done. And you will see record.combine has done the example carefully. So that's how record.combine is going to work. So record.fieldCount is going to count the number of fields in your record. Record to list is going to convert a list of that record. Let me show you how record.list is working. Comma, record.list. List. So simply again I'm moving dot equal record to list. Here I'm going to put records. A is equal to 1, comma, B is equal to 2, comma, C is equal to, let's say this time I'm taking no logicals or booleans. So here we have true and falses. So record to list, copy and paste, and done. And you will see this time we are getting value of all the records. So that's how we are going to work with record. Now one function here we have. Here we have two functions left, record.field or default. So what is going to do? It is going to basically serve a purpose that is going to serve by record.addField. Now the last function is record.transformField. In the last video we have not covered list.transform. Here I am again leaving this record.transform because I want to make a single video of these transformation function, record.transform, list.transform and table.transform. So see you in next video. Till then you can subscribe the channel and keep enjoying and keep learning.